Pablo Picasso, Hillary Clinton, Joe Biden, Christopher Columbus, Theodore Roosevelt, Jimmy Kimmel, Whoopi Goldberg, Virat Kohli, Sania Mirza. Well, they're all Scorpios and so am I. You thought different, hadn't you? Well, I do not feel the need to cushion my talk on people with mental health by comparing it with famous personalities, you know? Just because they had it, so it's okay if you have it too. I mean, do we ever really talk like that about people who have dialysis or a heart attack? So come, let us unravel this journey of assumptions, conditioning, mindsets, and create the unlearning together. I am Sheenu Jhawar, with about 48 years of experience of life, 25 of professional ups and downs, and pretty much 5 in the space of researching mental health. Years ago, when I was still in the NHS and going through my own phase of unlearning, I was hearing about a lot of subjects that were going on when I was doing my clinical audit. Out of these, there was one which hit me pretty hard. Mothers that had depression. Mothers that had babies but had depression. And mothers who were carrying babies and had depression. Yeah, what my tone and what my language today conveys is exactly what I felt back then. What? Quite intrigued, I spoke to a few gynecologists back home in India with this narrative. And that's when I started encountering a string and a row upon row of misconceptions. Hashtag one, mental illness in mothers is not real. Hashtag two, mental illness is a sign of weakness. Followed by misconception, hashtag three, people with mental illness. Are you listening? People with mental illness, why don't you reach out? Why don't you talk? We are here. Tell us. We are listening. And while you're listening, let's bust that myth. You know, when you're in a bad dream, and as much as you try to, you want to get out of it, and you're trying to run, scream, punch, kick. You know, you want to do all sorts of these things, and you're doing them, but you just cannot move. A lot of us have experienced that at some point or the other. Or you open your mouth and nothing comes out. You feel absolutely frozen. It's like trying to break over the ice on the top and just trying to flung yourself and come out. And no matter how hard you try, nothing changes. Would you believe if I said to you that's exactly how the battle with mental illness feels like with individuals? And sometimes they say, I have my feelings kept entirely to myself. Because how much ever I try, I simply cannot find a language in which to describe myself. You know, when I said about listening, I think, you know, when people say to people suffering from mental illness, talk, we are there to listen. I don't think that you really need to do that, you know. You don't have to be there to listen. You just have to be there. You know, you just have to be there in the same room, in the same house, in the same society, in the same world. But very important, please let the others also just be. Don't package this disease in your mind, in your conversation, with shame. Be open to the fact that it is just a disease. Don't cushion it. Don't judge it. And no matter what else you do, please don't give it a second look. Mental health is the absence of mental illness. But is it really just that? It's also the state of emotional, psychological, and social well-being. Mental illness is not really a mood problem, and it has nothing to do with being lazy or, being weak. We live in an informed society, so let us be well-informed. Much like a heart attack that originates in the heart, or a malignancy that happens to a tissue, or a diabetes that happens to the pancreas. Mental illness is a biological problem, and it sits in the domain of the neurosciences. It is not a behavioral problem. That is just a symptom. It is in fact associated with changes in the brain's structure, function, and chemistry. There is so much that we do not yet know about the brain, about how it functions. Due to biological reasons such as experience of trauma, family history, and so many other things, it may affect the brain and it may create mental illness. What you and I continually need to understand is that the brain is the most important part of the body. And therefore, you know, just because you can't see mental illness, just because you can't see, like, for example, a broken bone or any other problem, it does not mean that it does not exist. We are still studying it. And the effects of the mental illness can be just as devastating, just as debilitating and detrimental to the family or to the individual. Do we really tell a person who's suffering from leukemia, stop thinking about the problem, get up, you know, get up with a song and a dance and talk to people, and we are there to listen and just be positive? Think about it. While we may do that to cheer them up, but what we actually and really provide is medication, help, support in the recovery, and expect with patients that although the road to recovery may be long, but there will be a U-turn. And that's exactly how it is with mental health too. The umbrella of mental health includes depression, anxiety, schizophrenia, bipolar mood disorder, and a lot more. And there's another thing. Mental illness is not like a cough, you know, which comes or happens because there is an exposure to the rhinovirus, the cold virus. It's actually a chronic illness. The analogy could be with that of back pain. You could very well now understand that it does not just happen. So this period for which mental illness actually sits inside the brain, inside a person for a very long period of time, sometimes decades, is called the prodrome. The onset happens due to reasons which are still being studied, and that's when you start seeing the symptoms. Even with the concept of the prodrome, which I'm sure is a news for a lot of you, do we still realize that it is actually very common? It could be anyone. The trouble is nobody wants to talk about it, and that makes everything worse. Well, but we are talking about it today. Why today, one may ask? Because your present circumstances don't determine where you can go, but they merely determine where you can start. World Mental Health Day is observed on the 10th of October every year, with the overall objective of raising awareness of mental health issues around the world and mobilizing efforts in the support of mental health. The day provides an opportunity for all stakeholders working on mental health issues to talk about their work and what more needs to be done to make mental health care a reality for people worldwide. Let us today use this very same opportunity to mainstream the conversation around mental health. Let us throw away all misconceptions and the conditioning that we have in our minds, in the very fabric of our societies. Let us relook at what is required from each one of us, which is not just to listen, but to talk. Guys, let us talk about mental health. Let us know 350 million people worldwide and 10% of India's population on last count has found to be depressed. And remember, this is the diagnosed figure. We are still not touching the prodrome, which is a large piece of iceberg under the water. Let us know that depression leads to diabetes, leads to heart attack, leads to stroke in the left hemisphere, and is also associated with heavy smoking, substance abuse. Let us know that candida infection, low blood pressure, deficiency of vitamin B12 are some of the things which can lead to mental health issues. But even then, forget about everything that I just said with this piece of news. Let us know that 80% of the mortality in depression is not due to depression. It's due to cardiovascular diseases and cancer, which lie undetected in a person with mental health issues because he never reaches a hospital. Does that hit you, or does that hit you hard? Let us know that countries spend just 2% of their health budgets on mental health. And here lies the opportunity, not just as a mental health enthusiast, but also as an entrepreneur. Let me tell you, assistance for mental health has never exceeded 1% of all development assistance for health. This is despite the fact that for every US dollar won which is invested in scaled up treatment for common mental disorders such as depression and anxiety, there is a return of $5 in improved health and productivity. And there is where the entrepreneur gets all excited. What could be a bigger celebration of hope than this year's World Mental Health Day's goal, increased investment in mental health across the world? A massive scaling up in the investment space, bringing stakeholders close together, bringing technologies close together, creating awareness. World Mental Health Day 2020 is an opportunity to commit. Let's change the world together, not one step at a time, but with a cacophony of voices, each singing its own tune, its own way to its own music, as long as we walk the same talk. Let us talk.